But what does it mean to succeed? Well, this is the, to me, the big news. This is a profile, analytical profile that we did of about 50 to 70 of these Hall of Fame organizations. And you see here how I've divided this in the left-hand side, private sector, the right-hand side, governments and nonprofits. And you can see vertically the four layers of the balanced scorecard, from financial to customer to process to learning. The basic idea behind the balanced scorecard was that there is a cause and effect relationship between your people and what they know, their effectiveness in executing a process to satisfy a customer to increase shareholder value. That's the underlying idea of balance. You know, people drive process, satisfy customers, create shareholder value. And what this chart shows you is kind of a summary of the profiles of these 50 or so winners. In the private sector, the average Hall of Fame company showed an increase over 3 years, increase in value of 150%. That's market cap, shareholder value, however you decide it. But if you had a market cap of $1 billion, 3 years later, you would have a market cap of $2.5 billion. Okay, so 150% growth in shareholder value. Now, how did they do that? Well, you know, they started with the customer. The customer measurement showed that customer satisfaction grew by 50% over this period. So you can see, begin to see the correlation. Customer satisfaction grows by 50%, revenue is up by 50%, shareholder value is up by 150%. How do they satisfy customers? Well, each one of them in the analytic work that they did to developing their strategy identified a key business process. And the process improved by 50%. So let's say they were a manufacturing company and the process is a new product development cycle. And their current cycle was a year. So after their strategy was rolled out, after the measurements were rolled out, you know, the organization grew, improved its key process measurement by 50%. And how do they do that? Well, new process requires new knowledge. They did it by improving the competencies of their people. New knowledge, new people. And finally, the new process, the new training, the new people lead to new process execution, lead to customer satisfaction, lead to shareholder value. Cause and effect. On the right-hand side, you see government and nonprofit organizations. Now, people used to say, well, you know, we're a private sector. We can't learn anything from the public sector. And people in the public sector were saying the same thing back to the private sector. The reality is, with one basic assumption, it's all the same, with one basic exception. The exception is that in the government and nonprofits, you have a mission. In the private sector, you have a mission, but your mission is to create shareholder value. It's a financial mission. It's the same across the sector. But in the nonprofit sector, it's not the same. You know, you might be the police department of Dubai, and your mission is to reduce the number of fatalities and due to road accidents. You might be the American Diabetes Association, and your mission is to reduce the incidence of diabetes, you know, in the populace. You might be the, the tax collector at the gates of South Korea ports, and your job is to reduce smuggling and drug smuggling and so forth. So, your mission is different. But once you've defined the mission, you still have customers, you still have processes, you still have people, and that's the so we found in practice that the structure of the balanced scorecard works equally well. But if you look at the scale, you know, it's almost identical. 150% to 150% growth in the mission measure or in shareholder value. 50% improvement in customer satisfaction for both sectors. 50 or 40% improvement in key process effectiveness for both sectors. And the one that's most interesting to me, I'd love to spend an hour or so, maybe some subsequent vision talking about that, but the way in which employee satisfaction improved, and there's a set of programs that are used to do this, you know, educating people on what the strategy is, et cetera, but 20% improvement in employee satisfaction leads to a reduction in employee turnover on the order of 50%. Now, when you start putting these numbers together, you know, think one of our Hall of Fame companies is a technology firm in Singapore named Data Dimensions, and they were experiencing turnover of 30% per year in key technical staff. You know, so here you are competing up against the IBMs of the world and installing software, and your staff, you're losing 30% of your staff every year and replacing them with a new 30% and educating them and then letting them leave. And you see on both the public and the private sector, employee satisfaction leading to great reductions in employee turnover. So now you try to create that picture in your head. Well, I am doing something overt as a manager to develop my people, and they like it. I'm increased the training days. I'm sending them off-site. I'm building an executive development program. I'm doing a host of things, and they like it, and they stay. You know, employee turnover drops by 40%. Now, what does that mean? Well, the next part of my strategy calls for me to improve the business process. Now I get people who've decided to stay. They know that business process. They also know that customer. And so the customer is going to stay with you, buy more, because you kept those people. And so it's this cause and effect, and it's the same whether you're in the nonprofit or the private sector. So it works, and I would say the numbers are dramatic. 150% improvement in shareholder value is a dramatic outcome. You know, it's one to which you have to pay attention. You know, it's one that is worth saying, this is worth trying. If this new method of management can achieve these kinds of results, this is worth giving it a try. So that's 22 years of kind of history and evolution. So I'd like to talk a bit with you now about some of the how we do it and some of the issues. I mean, there's a lot of things, parts to this, and many parts I don't probably understand myself, but I want to talk to you about some of the things that we do understand. So the first is, how do we do it? It's one thing to say, here's my measures, my mission measures, and so forth. It's something else to say, how do I take those measures and build them into a management system? And in our most recent book, Bob Kaplan and I, the book's called The Execution Premium, and we talk about this idea of a closed loop system, you know, that has six basic components to it. Develop the strategy, translate the strategy so it can be understood, you know, create a balanced scorecard, measures and so forth. Align the organization. This is probably the single most important thing we do. When we start, we're trying to describe what the strategy is, and so we use the convention of measures to describe that. But once we have described what the strategy is, we now are able to take all of the programs, the investments that are being made, and focus them on the strategy. It's alignment. It's called alignment. And alignment is the key to success. Alignment is the reason, or lack of alignment is the reason most organizations have problems, you know, with executing strategy, because they're putting their money in different places. 60% of organizations don't tie their budgets to their strategy, you know, so you kind of get the picture. 80% of organizations, you know, spend less than an hour a month talking about strategy. You know, they don't. 95% of the workforce doesn't understand the strategy. So you get all these things, you know, that you couldn't really tie and focus and align to in the past. You know, now with a balanced scorecard, with a strategy map, you can, in fact, create this alignment. So alignment is the key. So I talked about One, develop the strategy. Two, translate it. Three, align the organization. Four, push it to the people. Make strategy everyone's job. Five, build it into your feedback loop. You know, 80-90% of organizations spend less than an hour a month. You should be not be one of those organizations. And then finally, test the strategy and update it. Strategy is a hypothesis. You know, you're not sure it's going to work. You think it'll work, but you're not sure. So you put it in place, you start funding it, you start managing it, and you test it, basically. You test the hypothesis as you go forward.